Well, hey guys, this is Super Steve here again. I'm honestly not sure if many people are watching, but I'll see how this goes after a time. Maybe I need to find a way to do better quality videos. Because this is, it's not the worst quality, but it's not the best quality. Anyway, let me know what you guys think, if you don't mind. But anyway, today I'm doing a reaction to My Little Pony: Friendship is Magic, Season 7, Episode 16, Campfire Tales. One second. I have seen screenshots to this from other reactors. That's just going to be a spoiler factor for me, unfortunately. But I haven't seen the episodes. I haven't read the description of what it's about. So I'm looking forward to watching this and the next episode, actually. Seeing screenshots of that, so I'm like curious on the whole changeling thing. But anyway, right now the Campfire Tales episode, see how it goes. And okay. What? Okay. Rarity and Applejack camping.
Folks are looking good.
And
we make good time today.
Fluttershy?
At this rate, we'll be in Winsome Falls by tomorrow.
We should do the annual Big Sister, Little Sister camping trip every weekend.
Then it wouldn't be annual. And if we did it every weekend, it probably wouldn't be as special.
Yeah.
But the more we do it, the better we get at camping. Remember the first time we came here and Rarity had that ginormous tent?
I heard that.
I've got much better at roughing it, haven't I?
Yep, this time you only packed 3 suitcases.
I know what you're thinking, but I promise I only brought the essentials.
Like those light thingies?
Of course. What is life if you can't make it beautiful?
Whatever.
These berries look good enough to eat.
Oh boy.
I still get a little bit scared out here, even after the last camping trip.
Yep.
Don't worry, kid. You've got a big sister this time.
Nice.
This looks amazing. This is gonna be the best big sister / little sister camping trip ever.
That get the bug. What the? Apple Bloom needs her fake old cutie mark. Anyway. Run. That's all to say about that. Get out of there. Forget it. Bugs. Yeah. Okay. Created Defender of Equestria doing his thing. Never mind. Oh, that's what I saw.
Everybody run for cover.
Where are they?
Get stuck in their web.
Goodness sake.
Follow me, pony.
Get out of there. Forget it. Make a hurricane to blow them away or something, I don't know. Forget it, Scootaloo, just get in there.
Where did those terrible bugs come from? Why did they destroy our camp? Look,
gliders are from the Luna Bay area. Never seen them this far east, though. Probably attracted to the food. Best wait here until they're gone.
Oh, Applerot! What are we supposed to do now? We had games to play.
girls want to. Maybe we can tell some stories to pass the time.
You want stories? I've got a ton of stories. Spoiler alert, they're all about me and how awesome I am.
Oh, I was thinking more like campfire stories.
But we don't even have a campfire. I got this.
Wow, that was brave.
It was no biggie.
Saw that screenshot, but oh well.
We aren't gonna tell scary stories like our last camping trip, are we? It's bad enough just being
My
angry.
Goodness,
Don't worry, Scooter. I was gonna tell you mine and Apple Bloom's favorite legend.
Oh, you mean Rockhoof? I love that one! He was so strong, and funny. Apple Bloom? Shh, you haven't heard it yet. Oh, okay, but it's so good!
Well, it's true. Rockhoof was known far and wide for his incredible strength. But he didn't start out that way. You see, Rockhoof was a tiny little fellow, the son of a farmer.
Just like us.
No,
they
son.
Lived in a village that sat at the foot of a gigantic volcano.
Okay.
The village was protected by an elite group of guard ponies called the Mighty Hell.
Where is this?
Young Rockhoof wanted nothing more than to be part of the Mighty Hell.
How
he was too scrawny and weak to protect the village.
How to Train Your Dragon much? This is so How to Train Your Dragon. Or a sidestep of it.
But Rockhoof wouldn't take no for
an answer. This is so How to Train Your Dragon.
Then, one fateful day, the volcano erupted.
Except the volcano part.
The molten lava poured down the side of the volcano. And try as they might, the Mighty Helm couldn't figure out a way to save the village. They had to evacuate. But the village ponies didn't want to leave their homes. They spent their entire lives there. They had nowhere else to go.
You want to leave or die? Your choice. Yeah.
So Rockhoof decided to do something crazy.
Divert the lava?
He thought if he could divert the flow of the lava, he might be able to save his village.
I called it.
He started digging a trench.
Wait a minute. All by himself? It'd be impossible for one pony to dig a trench fast enough to stop the lava. I mean, even I couldn't do that.
Mod might.
Good thing Rockhoof didn't believe in the word impossible. He continued to work, knowing the odds were against him, but determined to push through. Then, something magical happened. Rockhoof got visibly stronger, but the lava was getting closer.
Well, okay. Stuff.
Through his extraordinary determination and sheer force of will, Rockhoof more than earned his place.
Okay. Big old. Make a hurricane, blow them away.
Work is ruined.
There, there, sweetie Belle. Not to worry.
How? Our camp was so pretty and this cave is so... not.
Oh, no. Not true. There's beauty in everything. Even these blah rocks aren't really blah. If you look closely, you can see flecks of gold in them. And the way the firelight dances on the cave wall... shadow and light. Oh, it's so gorgeous. Sweetie Belle, have I ever told you about my favorite legend.
No, I didn't know you had one.
Her name was Mistmaine.
Mistmaine?
Okay.
Isn't she the old wrinkly sorceress with the flower?
Yes, but did you know she used to be the most beautiful unicorn in all the land?
No.
So what happened to her?
Well, Mistmaine was a very promising young sorceress. She was as talented as she was beautiful and kind. Every pony loved her and missed her when she was sent to the
different unicorns. Especially her. I saw that screenshot as well of her, but I didn't think it was all a village of those type of unicorns.
While she was gone, she was delighted to find out that her best friend, Sable Spirit, was crowned Empress. She couldn't wait to return home once she finished her studies. But once she arrived, she was devastated by what she saw.
What happened here?
The Empress happened. She makes every pony work day and night on her palace. We don't have time to take care of anything else.
Well, that can't be. I know her. She would never do this.
But there was no denying what was in front of her.
So what's up?
Sable Spirit took everything that was beautiful away from any pony else. Mistmaine was sure there had to be some explanation.
I'd assume there was too, if some pony told me either one of you two'd gone evil.
Yeah, I'd never believe it.
I don't know. I've seen the way you two get when you miss breakfast. Just kidding. But I want answers too.
So did Mistmaine. She went to confront her friend.
Don't tell me you don't recognize your old friend.
I don't. My friend would never work our families and friends to the bone for something as silly as a palace.
Silly? My palace is a beacon of beauty. Any pony who passes will be in awe of its majesty.
What good is a pretty palace if it just hides the misery of its ponies?
Beauty is everything. You taught me that.
What?
You were always the pretty one. You got to go to the best magic school. Every pony missed you. Every pony loved you. I admit I was jealous. So I tried to perform a spell that would make me beautiful. You can see how that went.
Yeah.
I vowed if I couldn't have beauty, I would take it. I wasn't chosen to be empress, you know. I took it. Just like I'm going to take everything else.
I can't let you do that.
Let me.
That's how the screenshot I've heard too. I really should avoid YouTube a few days and do the reaction soon. Anyway, well. Well, that's a thing. Well,
every pony thought Sable Spirit was defeated, and that was that. But Mistmaine knew there was more she could do to help. Beauty isn't everything, but Mistmaine knew that it does have the power to make ponies smile. She made a huge sacrifice to bring that smile back to her friends and family's faces.
Did this for me, even after I was so cruel?
Sable Spirit was so touched that she vowed to be more like her friend in the ways that mattered. From then on, she ruled with kindness and compassion.
That was a good story. Man.
Even though she gave away her physical beauty, she dedicated her life to spreading beauty all over Equestria. Anytime you go out of your way to brighten some pony's day by doing something like giving them flowers, you're following in the hoofsteps of Mist Mane. I think she's my favorite legend, too.
That's cool. Stuff. Bugs. Gliders?
Well, like it or not, we're food too.
And I've got the bites to prove it. What are we gonna do? They're almost here!
Oh boy, well, stuff.
What? Now those bugs can't get in.
We can get out. Not a good idea.
Just have to wait until the
whatever, it's a cartoon.
Then we'll think of a way out. How long will that be? Some bears live in caves?
Whoa, Scootaloo, you're focusing on the wrong things.
You have a plan?
Close. I have a story.
Let me guess. It's about you?
Practically. It's about my favorite legend, Flesh Mates.
What?
Wasn't he the pony who took on the dragons?
Dragons? Big scary mean ones are like Spike.
Oh, these were definitely the big scary mean kind.
But not too scary. You can sit closer to me if you want.
Long time ago, before the Wonderbolts were even founded, Flash Magnus was a lowly cadet to the Royal Legion.
Okay. I think I might have seen that screenshot, but that was still funny.
Flash Magnus and the Royal Legion tried to get past the dragons. But the dragons wouldn't let them.
Well, what's his name?
Everypony, retreat!
Ember's father.
Flash Magnus and a few other cadets were separated from the battalion. He managed to get away, but the dragons captured his friends and took them back to their lair.
Dragons is going to be impossible. Nothing will work.
The commander was right. You can't outfight dragons.
But you can outthink them.
Commander Ironhead, I'm pretty sure I can outfly the dragons. If I can lure them into chasing me, you can all sneak into the lair and retrieve our friends before they get back.
Are you really willing to take that chance?
I am, sir.
It's a very brave thing you're doing. You'll need all the help you can get.
Is this the Titus? The fireproof shield?
It has protected Legion heroes for generations, and today, I can't think of a worthier flank for the Titus to protect. Good luck, soldier.
His soldiers back.
That's one way to do it. Yeah.
And the dragons retreat.
What about him? I guess he's okay.
Magnus's plan worked.
Yes. Cool.
Told ya! He always inspired me to be my brave and awesome self.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess he kind of reminds me of you.
You guess? Come on! I'm just like him!
Hey, do you hear that?
I don't hear anything.
Exactly. Those gosh darn flighters are gone. We can get out.
Once you can get out... Fly. Yeah, that works too.
What do you know? We found ourselves a shortcut to Windsor Falls.
Oh, it's never looked so beautiful. Well, almost.
Sure are sorry that our camping trip wasn't what we hoped it would be.
Are you kidding? This trip is awesome!
It is?
We got to hear legendary stories and go on an adventure.
Wait, you three want to stay?
Of course we do. We could turn those trees into a nice little shelter. We can get you some big logs and branches to help build it. And I bet we can find some more berries. Come on. I can't wait to see what happens next year.
Good episode. One moment. Good episode. Remember a few good stories. My favorite one was the one where what's her name give up her beauty to make things better for everyone else. So, man, self sacrifice. And considering how how people or ponies look on outside beauty, it's significant. That's no small sacrifice. So, yeah. Alright, well, I guess I'm going to start the next episode shortly, so I'm just going to turn this off and change things. So, I guess for now, bye-bye till next episode.